Hello and welcome to the episode 33 of What a Fab Day. I am your host, Simon Mas. Today's highlights include the start of a tour, more studio work, and rehearsals for a live appearance. On the 2nd of February 1961, the Beatles, with Pete Best on drums, played the Litherland Town Hall in Liverpool. In 1962, still featuring Pete Best on drums, the lads performed at the Oasis Club in Manchester. While this particular engagement was brought on by the interest of the club's owner, Tony Stewart, one can say that manager Brian Epstein was starting to make good on his promises to enlarge the range of venues that would book the band, particularly outside Liverpool. According to bootleg recordings of the evening, the Beatles performed the following songs: The Hippie Hippie Shake, Sweet Little 16, The Sheik of Araby, September in the Rain, Dizzy Miss Lizzy, Take Good Care of My Baby, Till There Was You, Memphis, Tennessee, What a Crazy World We Live In, Like Dreamers Do, Money, That's What I Want, Young Blood, The Honeymoon Song, Hello Little Girl, So How Come No One Loves Me, Oh My Soul, To Know Her Is to Love Her, Roll Over Beethoven, The Love of the Loved, Dance and Twist in the Streets, Dream and Searching. Another live performance in 1963, but this time it's a first. It's the opening night for the first national package tour to which the Beatles took part, at the bottom of a bill including the Ted Price Band, the Honeys, Danny Williams, the Kenstrels, Kenny Lynch and Helen Shapiro. The 16-year-old Shapiro, voted Best British Female Singer in 1961 and 1962, was heading the tour, although, some said, her career was already stalling. It speaks volume about the staying power of pop stars of the early 1960s. The day started in the freezing cold, the warmest temperature throughout UK for the day was -1°C, at Alsop Place in London, where most musicians got on the bus that would have brought them to Yorkshire, to the Beaumont Cinema in Bradford. That night, the Beatles performed Chains, Keep Your Hands Off My Baby, A Taste of Honey, and Please Please Me. The band also prepared Love Me Do, Long Tall Sally, and Beautiful Dreamer as alternatives for the remaining dates of the tour. It was naturally a big moment for the lads. They were accompanied by manager Brian Epstein, dressed in a white suit for the occasion. Epstein, it seems, had to sweat quite a bit to have a picture of the band taken by photographer Stan Richardson, who was covering the start of the tour for Melody Maker. Richardson did take one picture of the Beatles, but refused to take more because, in his experience, pop acts routinely failed to pay photographers for their work, and he doubted Melody Maker would have been interested in more than a picture of this unknown band. In 1964, the Beatles performed another two slots at the Olympia Theatre in Paris, France. Moving to the 2nd of January 1967, we get more work on Sgt. Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band at the EMI Studios in Abbey Road. The session, taking place between 7 p.m. and 1:45 a.m., started with Paul McCartney overdubbing another vocal track on take 9. The material was then reduced to take 10, freeing more tracks for further work. These reductions we're talking about were copies of different tracks on an empty one, with a quick mixdown done on the fly, so that the reduced tracks could be erased and the band could continue placing overdubs on the song they were working on. The procedure was needed because of the relatively few tracks available on the machines at the time, 4 in case of the EMI Studios. The resulting track could have, for example, a guitar part, some percussions and a keyboard on it. Erasing just one of the existing elements would not be possible unless one wanted to record everything on that track again. Anyhow, before the end of the session, a rough mono mix of the work so far was prepared to give everyone the chance to check on the progress in the tranquility of their home. In 1968, Ringo Starr was again at the television rehearsal rooms in North Acton, London, for off-camera daytime rehearsals for his appearance on the second season of Cilla Black's BBC TV series. In the meantime, between 12 noon and 1 pm, George Martin was in Abbey Road, making a copy of the Only a Northern Song vocal track, probably to include it in the soundtrack of the Yellow Submarine film. None of the Beatles was present. In 1970, Ringo Starr and his wife Maureen took a plane from New York City to London. This concludes the current episode of What a Fab Day. Remember that some of the episodes have been recorded in a deluxe version with extra commentaries. They're not available yet, but when they will, I will explain how to acquire them on my website, and particularly on www.simonmas.com/support. Make sure that you regularly check that link if you are interested, and please show any appreciation you might have for my work. Even sharing the link with your friends or leaving me a message, those help. In the episode description, you will find a link to the bibliography of the podcast, with many Amazon affiliate links in case you fancied helping me with your shopping. For the moment, I wish you a good day and a fab continuation. Simon Mas, music you love.